be home for Christmas. You can count on.
I'll be home for Christmas. She was only about 4'11", but she had the biggest heart I had ever seen. Being a mother can sometimes be a stressful and tiresome job, but my mom always did it without complaint. The love of a mother is a bond that is unbreakable. My mother was an only child, and she came from humble beginnings. She never had much, and truth be told, she never really wanted much. She was just a simple woman who enjoyed being with her children and grandchildren. I'm not sure we deserved to have been blessed with such an amazing mother, but I can tell you I'm sure glad we were. We definitely took advantage of Mom's unconditional love at times. And my mom always told us, each gray hair on my head comes from a time when I worried about one of you. And sadly, we gave her way too much to worry about. But Mom never complained. She just gave us all regular helpings of love and support throughout our lives. She never asked for anything and taught each one of us the true meaning of sacrifice. All my mother ever asked from any of us kids was one thing. She said, "Please come home for Christmas." And I always told her, "Mom, I will be home for Christmas." I remember how my mother cried each year when we all gathered together at her house for Christmas. Each year she looked forward to this one event. Mom had a habit of calling each of us about 2 weeks out before Christmas every day just to remind us of the time. Mom orchestrated each Christmas gathering as if she was creating a masterpiece. This was her day, that one day where she could get all her babies together at the same time without any excuses. My mom's house was just a modest little home, but each year she transformed it into a gingerbread house. Yeah, the old house came alive with Christmas lights and decorations strewn about every room. When Mom opened the door to greet us, we were quickly welcomed by the aroma of Mom's dinner and fresh baked pies. It was always a fun gathering, and us kids didn't really see each other a lot throughout the year, so it also gave us the time to catch up. I guess it would be easy to say we were all just too busy with life, but that would really only be an excuse. The truth is, we just failed at that time to understand the importance of making time. Priorities can make or break a family, and Mom knew this. Us kids may have learned that lesson a little late in life. As exciting as our Christmas tradition was, I always dreaded having to say goodbye to my mother. My mom just couldn't hold back those tears, and seeing my mom cry just tore me up inside. It saddened me to see her sad. She deserved so much more than she ever got. See, my mom understood the pain and heartache of celebrating the holidays without loved ones. My mom lost her father when she was just a young girl, and she lost my grandmother at an early age as well. She cried when we arrived with tears of joy, but we all knew those tears would turn to sadness when it was time to say goodbye. One day I asked my mother, I said, "Mom, why do you have to cry every Christmas?" Her eyes filled with tears, and she looked up at me and she said, "Because I never know which one will be my last." Only a couple years after she spoke those words to me, she had enjoyed her last Christmas. See, Mom had been sick most of her life and spent a good portion of her life in and out of hospitals. Poor health had plagued my mother, and I have a harder time remembering a time she wasn't sick. That following Christmas was very hard on all of us. It just wasn't the same without Mom. In the basement of her home, sitting in a corner all alone, was Ma's beautifully decorated Christmas tree. It did have its share of dust, as Mom kept that tree up year-round. I think it was her way of feeling the closeness of her children. 61 Christmases is all she ever celebrated. As I got older, I started understanding just how Ma felt, why Christmas was so important to her. And those words she said still echo in my mind each Christmas, and she was right. You never know which Christmas is your last. Time is a battle we must all face, and a war we will inevitably lose. I think a lot about Christmases past. I think about Mom, my son, and all those loved ones we have lost. I find myself quietly looking around the dinner table each Christmas and remembering their laughs and smiles. While those chairs may be empty, our hearts are full. Full of those wonderful memories and great times that we all shared together. No, I can't bring them back, but I can certainly keep their memories alive.